to the 150th day of the Swasthavati 65 Days Project. Today's topic is on epilepsy and seizures. What is epilepsy? Epilepsy is a neurological condition involving the brain that makes people more susceptible to have recurrent and unprovoked seizures. It is one of the most common disorders of the nervous system that affects people of ages, races and ethnic background. Almost 3 million Americans live with epilepsy. Anything that interrupts a normal connection between the nerve cells in the brain can cause a seizure. It may be due to high fever, low blood sugar, high blood sugar, alcohol or drug withdrawal or brain concussion. Under these circumstances, anyone having one or more seizures. However, when a person has two or more unprovoked seizures, then he or she is considered to have an epilepsy. There are many possible cases of epilepsy to imbalance of nerve signal chemicals called as neurotransmitters, tumors, stroke or brain damage from illness or injury or some combination of both. In majority of cases, there may be no detectable cause for epilepsy. So what is a seizure? The brain is a center that controls all the voluntary and involuntary responses in our body. It consists of nerve cells communicate with each other through electrical activity. Seizure occurs when parts of brain receives a burst of abnormal electrical signal that temporarily interrupts a normal electrical brain function. What are the different types of seizures? The type of seizures depend upon on which of the part of the brain is affected and what happens during the seizure. The two broad categories of epileptic seizures are generalized seizures, absence of atonic, tonic, clonical, myoclonical and partial, simple and complex seizures. Within these categories, there are several types of seizures including focal or partial seizures. Focal seizures that takes place when abnormal electrical brain functions occurs in one of the more areas on one side of the brain. Focal seizures may also be called partial seizures. With focal seizures, particularly with the complex focal seizures, a person may experience an aura, a premotion, before the seizure occurs. The most common aura involves feelings such as deja vu, impending doom, fear or europhea. Visual changes, hearing abnormalities or changes in sense of smell can also be auras. The two types of focal seizures include simple focal seizures and complex focal seizures. Simple focal seizures. The person may have different symptoms depending upon which of the area of the brain is involved. If the abnormal electrical brain function is in the occipital lobe, the back of the brain that is involved for vision, sight may be altered and muscles can also be commonly affected. The seizure activity is limited to an isolated muscle group such as fingers or to a larger muscles in arms and legs. Consciousness is lost in any type of seizures. The person may experience sweating, nausea and become pale. The complex seizures are a type of seizure occurs in the temporal lobe of the brain, the area that controls the emotion and the memory function. Consciousness is lost during both the seizures. Losing consciousness may not mean that a person passes out sometimes. A person stops being aware of what's going in and around him. The person may look away, but may be a variety of unusual behaviors. The behaviors may range from gagging, lip smacking, running, screaming, crying and laughing. When a person regains consciousness, he or she complains of a tired or sleepy after a seizure. This is called as postural period. Generalized seizures. Generalized seizures involves both the sides of the brain. There's a loss of consciousness and a postural state after the seizure occurs. Types of generalized seizures include absent seizures, also called as pitmal seizures. Seizures are characterized of brief, altered state of consciousness and starting episodes. Typically, the person postures maintained during the seizures. Month of face may twitch, from the eyes may blink rapidly. A seizure used to last longer than more longer than 30 seconds. When the seizure is over, the person may not recall what just occurred and may go on with his or her activities, and nothing happened. These seizures may occur several times a day. The type of seizures that sometimes mistaken from learning problem or behavioral problem. Absence of seizures also may always start between age of 4 to 12 years. Atonic or drop attacks. With atonic seizures, there is sudden loss of muscle tone and the person may fall from a standing position and suddenly drop his or her head. During the seizure time, the person is limp and unresponsive. Generalized tonic-clonic seizures. This is called GTC seizures or grand mal seizures. Classic form of this kind of seizures are, which may not occur in every case, but it is characterized by 5 distinct phases. The body, arms, legs will flex, contract, extend, strengthen up and tremor shake, following by a clonic period, contraction and relaxation of muscles, and a postural period. Note all these phases may be seen everyone with a type of seizures. During the postural period, the person may be sleepy with problems of vision or speech or having a bad headache, fatigue and body aches. myoclonic seizures. A type of seizures refers to quick movements or sudden jerking and group of muscles. These seizures tend to occur in clusters, meaning that they occur in several times a day or several days in a row. Infantile spasms. The rare type of seizure disorder occurs in infants before 6 months of age. There is a high occurrence of rate of this seizure when a child is awakening or when he or she is trying to go to sleep. The infant has usually a brief pace of movement of neck, tongue and legs. This can be a serious problem and can have long-term complications. Febrile seizures. The type of seizures associated with fever but not epilepsy. Although fever may trigger a seizure in a child who has an epilepsy, the seizures are more common in children between 6 months to 5 years of age, and there be a family history of type of seizures. Febrile seizures can at least for 15 minutes are called as simple and typically do not have long-term neurological effects. Seizures lasting more than 15 minutes can have complex and maybe long-term neurological changes in the child. What causes seizures? Now you are going to see the causing of seizures in newborns and infants, then in children, adolescents and adults. In newborns and infants, birth trauma, congenital present at birth problems, fever or infection, metabolic chemical imbalances in our body. In children, adolescents and adults, alcohol and drugs, head trauma. Head trauma as a result of car accident or other traumatic injury can cause epilepsy. Infection. Infectious diseases like meningitis, AIDS, viral encephalitis can cause epilepsy. Congenital diseases. Genetic factors. Some types of epilepsy which can be characterized by the type of seizure that you experience, the part of brain is affected. Then in families. In these cases, it is likely termed to be a genetic influence. Researchers have linked some type of epilepsy to specific genes. But most of the people, genes are not only a part of the cause of epilepsy. Certain genes make a person more sensitive to environmental conditions or trigger seizures. Progressive brain disease, Alzheimer's, stroke and unknown lesions. Other possible causes of seizures may include a brain tumor, neurological problems, drug withdrawal, medications and use of illicit drugs. And risk factors of seizures. Certain factors can cause risk factors for seizures or epilepsy. Age. Age is an important factor. The onset of epilepsy is most common in children and other in adults, but the condition occur at any age. Family history. If you have a family history of epilepsy, you may be at an increased risk for developing an epilepsy. Head injuries. Head injuries can be responsible for an epilepsy. You can reduce your risk by wearing a seatbelt when sitting in a car or wearing a helmet by riding or sitting in a scooter. Stroke and other vascular disorders. Stroke and other blood vascular diseases can lead to brain damage and may trigger epilepsy. You can take number of steps to reduce these by having a proper maintained diet, avoiding cigarettes and reducing the intake of alcohol. Dementia. Dementia can increase the risk of epilepsy. Brain infections, meningitis and several inflammation in your brain and spinal cord increases the risk of getting a seizure. Seizures in childhood. High fevers in childhood can be sometimes associated with seizures. The children who have seizures due to high fevers generally won't develop epilepsy. The risk of epilepsy increases if a child has a long seizure, another nervous system and family history of an epilepsy. Thank you.